the scriptures. Because some scriptures are classified as Purana. Purana literally means legendary stories. And there are some scriptures which are classified as itihas. You know, it's Sanskrit term, Gujarati term, itihas, history. The Ramayana and the Mahabharata, the Hindus claim, without hesitation, without feeling compromise, is itihas. It is not storytelling. It's not mere mythology. So we are very clear in our classification. Puran, we say, have fun. Lots of gods and goddesses messing around. That's fun. Look, this is how I got to Hinduism. Puran brought me here. So powerful stories. And yet, when we talk about the historicity, we say, look, the Ramayana and the Mahabharata are not just made-up stories. These are real historic accounts of some grand personalities of ancient India that really inspired that nation, that pulled that nation together. The story of Ram is just that. The story of Ram is how whole of India was reunited by one great personality, brought in the Northern Empire, in touch with the Southern Empire, and after winning a battle, he didn't say, I'm going to rule you and I'm going to be send you a governor. He said, we are friends, we are unified. We integrate and assimilate best from both the civilizations and make a greater civilization. This is the story of Ram. People don't realize that part. He unified the whole of the Indian subcontinent first time. So here is the, if you like, real giants of Hinduism that did tremendous work for India of Hinduism. This is not mythology. There was a great personality, a supreme personality called Ram, or a supreme personality called Krishna, who inspired India to the marvelous ideas of religion. So we can't call them mythology. Be careful. So the Bhagavad Gita is very much part of the Mahabharata story. And the Bhagavad Gita, the reason why I like the Bhagavad Gita is because some of the most subtle ideas in the Upanishads, in the philosophy of Hinduism, kind of were looking as if they are not well reconciled. And this Krishna, in a marvelous way, managed to reconcile the different strands of Hinduism in just one booklet with 700 verses called the Bhagavad Gita. That is why all Hindus will swear on the Bhagavad Gita. It's a synthesis of all the Upanishadic teachings. It's a synthesis of everything good and grand about Hinduism. So it's not a minor volume. So you can't call it mythology. Now, let me also give a health warning. I like to give health warnings all the time. Sometimes, when you see some of these stories of the Mahabharata coming on TV, a lovely story, Ramanand Sagar, with Ram wearing silk clothes and golden ornaments and fighting a big battle with a huge temple above his head. I suspect if it was anything like that. So you must recognize that these stories have historic foundation, and yet the present manufactured stuff has been compromised. It has been made kind of suitable for us. So we need silk clothes and clean-shaven Ram. I doubt he was clean-shaven, but he was using Gillette blades, So the thing is, we must smile. It doesn't mean the story is gone, story is wrong. The modern depiction is definitely compromised. Once you know that, then you can smile. And you can still relate to the story of Ram, relate to the story of Krishna, and recognize the modern version is bit kind of more, more kind of TV oriented. So it's like they've turned into soap operas. I just saw the story about Shiva, and they've turned into poor little Shiva and Parvati. They are saying dialogue and kind of tussle, and they're like soap opera. I said, this is terrible. But the Hindus like to wallow in sentimentality, churn everybody up, all these emotions, husband and wife and, in-laws and all these, churn it up even with the gods and goddesses. They loved it. This is our nature. What to do?